A lot of sunshine and a chilly, brisk afternoon for us out there with temperatures only in the 20s to lower half of the 30s. Of course, with the wind, it's going to feel a lot colder than that. And what is a full sunshiny day for us today turns mostly sunny tomorrow and sunshine to clouds on Wednesday, as that system moving across the country, producing severe weather in the deep south today, eventually gets to the coastline tomorrow morning and blossoms into a large coastal storm that again will try to track somewhere close to the southeast coast of New England. Till we get there, it looks like sunshine today with temperatures in the 20s to lower half of the 30s. Tonight, single digits to teens again, 0 to 15 will be the range for overnight lows, only to get back into the 30s just about statewide tomorrow. A couple of southern spots could even reach 40 degrees tomorrow afternoon. The change on Wednesday will be some morning sunshine giving way to clouds as that system slowly lifts up the east coast. Right now we are on the northwestern fringes of that chance of snow. How far inland, how far north and west across the state that goes, if at all, is the million-dollar question. And when you're on a northwestern fringes of a system, a matter of 20 to 40 miles and a track of this is going to make all the difference to exactly what we see out of it. Again, most of it will be after the evening commute on Wednesday and probably wrapping up before the morning commute on Thursday, which will at least have a smaller impact as far as the timing is concerned. But it is something we'll keep tabs on, still a solid 1500 miles away from making its way here, and we'll watch the latest computer maps as they come in this afternoon. Sunshine, chilly breeze, 20s to lower 30s, but feeling colder than that with the wind, which will be lighter out there with the sunshine tomorrow. Clouds will increase Wednesday, and again, that window of time looks to be sunset Wednesday through about sunrise Thursday for any sort of possible snow. Right now looks like light accumulation most likely possible, if it's going to happen, in southeastern areas.